Hi guys, thank you for clicking on this video. Recently I put on my Instagram and YouTube community that I was going to be doing a Q&A. So I asked you to leave me some questions to answer in this video. I feel it's quite nice doing Q&As now and again as we can interact with each other. I don't always have the time or see everybody's comments, so by leaving any questions you have or advice or anything, it's easier for me to answer them on this video. And if I missed your question, I didn't get it for whatever reason, then I will definitely do another one of these, so you can just leave a question then. Obviously it is an absolutely crazy time at the minute with COVID-19 and a lot of places being in lockdown. It's definitely something to adjust to, and there's a lot of change. I know a lot of you would be out starting to camp or going on hiking trips or canoe trips, things like that, especially now the warmer weather is here. Spring is here, which is such a nice feeling, especially surrounded by all these bluebells and just leaves. It's absolutely stunning. It is a letdown. It is a real shame, but I guess by staying in and social distancing or isolating is going to help in the long run and shorten the process of this. So yeah, it's definitely scary times, and I hope everyone's doing well and staying positive and happy and keeping themselves entertained. Whatever you're doing, maybe you're isolating at home or you're isolating with somewhere else, or maybe you're one of the frontline workers who are risking their lives to help other people, which is just so amazing. Whether you work for the NHS, you're a doctor, or you're working in a supermarket or something like that, just to keep our society ticking over and keep it running. So yeah, we're definitely, I think everyone's really thankful for them people, and that's why we kind of got to do our part with social distancing and isolating ourselves away from friends and places with a lot of people. I think this experience being in lockdown will definitely let us appreciate the freedom we did have with going travelling anywhere you wanted to wild camp and just get out when you wanted to. Definitely appreciate what we did have and the friends and the family we do have. And hopefully people will show more appreciation and gratitude towards the outdoors and treat it with a little bit more respect maybe in the long run. So anyway, I hope you're all well and enjoying your time, and maybe this video will distract your time in lockdown or keep you entertained. I know someone already has gone through all my videos right from the start and working their way up watching them, so it must be quite desperate times. But that is really sweet. I appreciate that. So anyway, I'm going to work through these questions you kindly all given me. I asked you to upload questions on Instagram yesterday and YouTube today, so I probably won't get everyone's questions in if they do it a little bit later, but like I said, I'll do it in another video. First question is, how old are you? I am 18. It feels weird saying I'm 18 now, because it's just, I don't know, it's one of those ages where you're sort of turning into an adult. But yeah, I had a really nice birthday. Usually people would go out for their 18th, but obviously that's not the case with lockdown. But yeah, it was nice spending it with my family. Obviously, you should appreciate this time with your loved ones and your family. So yeah, that was that. Next question is Rob Cockburn. Enjoyed your Scotland video. Where are you planning on heading next? Yeah, thank you for watching my video. At the minute, I'm not going to plan any trips. I just think that's the best way. We don't know when this is going to end, when lockdown or the virus is going to eventually stop. So, yeah, there's no deadline on this. So I guess it would be sensible to not really plan anything and get my hopes up. Because it would just be more of an anti-climax. Say I do plan something for July and we're still in lockdown, I'll probably be more gutted if I didn't plan anything. But yeah, definitely once this is near in the end, whenever that is, I will plan something out. I was hoping on doing the West Highland Way this year in Scotland. It's a 100-mile trail across the Scottish Highlands. That was my plan for this year, and learning how to drive and travelling around this country first, but that hasn't gone to plan. But yeah, I'll just see. There's definitely a lot of places that I want to visit and see, and it's made me want to travel more so now we don't have that freedom to travel. Next one is, how is your days going on during lockdown? My days have been really nice, actually. Me and my family decided to isolate on private land, so it's pretty much away from a lot of people, don't see anyone, so it's really good way of self-isolating. And it's obviously given me a lot of time to reflect on myself and spend time with my family and learn new skills. So yeah, I've been learning a lot of new skills. I bought loads of books up and just flicking through them, trying to gain knowledge and test out different skill sets, which has been quite interesting. And yeah, it's been really good. It's definitely a lot of skills that I wanted to work on, and this has given me a lot of time to do them. Next question is from Tabs to Travel. Is there anything you wished would come back into fashion? I don't know if you mean clothing or just in general. I wish sort of exploration and outdoor pursuits would be in fashion, because obviously that isn't a well-liked thing at the minute. That isn't very popular, especially around near me or in the UK in general. It would be good to see people more interested in the outdoors. That would be really nice. I remember when I worked with Forest School, with kids, teaching them outdoor skills, they loved it, really enjoyed it. And I guess as you get older, you kind of distance yourself from that, and yeah, it's not really a thing. So it's really rare to find someone who likes outdoor camping and doing this sort of thing. So yeah, that would be quite nice. But obviously on the same token, it's nice that it's a unique thing to do, as outdoor places would be packed, I guess, if everyone wanted to do it. Next question is from Lee Dicko 7. My favourite part of the Lake District. I've only been there once with Mike and Miles, so I obviously don't know it that well. We covered quite a lot of it whilst we were there. We were there about 6 days, so we travelled around quite a lot of it. So I'm not an expert, but I'll say from my time there, I would say my favourite place would be, I think it was Wasdale. So there was this beautiful lake, I think it's Wastwater, something like that. I think it's a reservoir or something. It was absolutely stunning because you've got Scarfell Pike behind it, and then you've got this really cute little pub that was really nice. And then if you go further down, there's a really, really old church that was built by Vikings. I think it was Olaf Church or something. and there was so much history. They've got actual Viking boats on the ceiling to build the structure of it. So the construction work on that was amazing, especially considering how old it is. And just the place is stunning. It's just surrounded by loads of mountains, and then you've got that beautiful stretch of reservoir. And when we were there, it was bright sun, and there was a really, really nice sunset. So it looked stunning, and I loved it there. The whole of the Lake District is really pretty, but I'd say from my trip there, that would be the winner. The next one is Bukit Nami. Sorry if I get any of these names wrong. Did you have worse experience when in Woodland? I'm guessing that's, what's your worst experience? I would say I haven't really had any bad experiences. It's pretty been plain sailing. I've never got into much difficulty. But I'd say it would have to be, I did a survival challenge, I think it was like 2 years ago. It was like minimal gear, 24 hours or something like that. And basically I had a nice little raised bed going on, and I had a fire reflector, obviously to reflect heat and keep me warm because I didn't have proper gear and it was quite cold. And what happened is I built the fire so hot, and because I was just, I wanted to keep warm because I knew it would be a cold night. And I woke up to find that the firewall had caught light, and it was just this huge fire, and it was so hot. I think that's what woke me up. And I think it was just the panic of it, and the thought of starting a forest fire would be awful. And remember jumping up. I didn't have much water because it was a minimal gear challenge. I think I just had a bottle of water, and it wasn't enough to put this out. So I was digging. It was like in the middle of the night. I'm digging with my hands, soil to chuck on the fire just to calm it down. Eventually it did work, but it was just a fright and a shock because that had never happened to me before. And fire's obviously a really deadly thing. Thing to work with, and it can cause a lot of destruction. So that would have been absolutely terrifying and horrible if I burnt part of a woodland down. Yeah, so definitely learnt from that, but I'd say that's probably a worse experience but a really good learning curve. Next question is from Shorty_Roth. What will be your next project? Probably a lot. There's a lot of skills that I really want to work on. I got my hand drill set out the other day, had a little go on that. I've started on my teepee shelter. I took it down, it was in one location. I took it all down, transported it all to a new location where the bell tent is. And now I've just got to build it all back up again. So I've got to weave all sticks around it and sort of waterproof it, and then just cover it and do whatever I want inside. So probably do that soon. Next one is from vegan_Putins. Do you have a favourite knife/axe? I would say my favourite brand of knives would be TBS. I've got two of their knives. Absolutely brilliant. I've got the TBS Boar and the TBS Puka. Can't really remember the name, but I feel quite ashamed for that. But I really like TBS knives. Use them all the time. They're my main bushcraft knives. Mora also do some brilliant knives, and they're for a really decent price. Next one is from Shorty_Roth again. What is your next travel destination? So, like I said to the other question, which is quite similar, I'm just going to wait and see how long lockdown will last and how long the virus is going to last for, and then plan after that, I guess. Next question is from C.Strong. Do you ever think about hiking in America? All the time. I would love to hike and camp in America. That's definitely something on my bucket list. I'm a real fan of South America, like Peru, but also just there's so many beautiful places in America. It's mind-blowing. And also Canada and Alaska. I just love that whole stretch of a country, of different countries even. PCT looks awesome. I really want to do that someday. Just amazing. That's a really long distance trail if you haven't heard of it. But hopefully one day. Fingers crossed. Next one is from RizWanali_Shah. Hope I got that right. When do you start camping? I've always gone on campouts since I was little. But I never, it would just be a few times a year, nothing major. I think getting properly into this and bushcraft was when I was about 15. So it's been quite a long time now, thinking back. And then soon after, I set up this YouTube channel. So yeah, around 15. Next question is from Sammy Brown. Best outdoor clothing, tops and bottoms. Best outdoor trousers for me personally would be, for bushcraft, the Far Ravens I've got. I'll put the exact brand. I was kindly given them from a subscriber called Barry, so cheers for that. I absolutely love them. Favourite trousers for bushcraft. Just because they're really thick material, so when you're on your knees a lot doing bushcraft, lighting fires and things like that, it's a lot of protection on your knees, and the water doesn't really seep through if it's wet on the floor. I also love that it's got loads of pockets. There's two huge pockets on your legs and then two normal pockets around your hips, so I love that. They're also really comfortable, and they've got a nice setting on the bottom to adjust around your boots or whatever footwear you're wearing. For hiking, I would choose the Crag Hoppers. I've got a really nice pair of them. I wore them pretty much the whole time I was in Scotland. They're just really flexible, they're easy to bend in, and really comfortable. You obviously, when you're hiking, want a nice, comfortable pair of trousers. So yeah, they're really breathable as well. I also like that in the pocket, they've got a little cleaner for cleaning my camera screen or whatever you want to clean with it, but I use it for my camera, and it's just handy because if my camera's got a smear on it, I can quickly get out my pocket and wipe it down. So I like that idea with it. For outdoor tops, I would choose the base layers I use are the Helly Hansen base layer, but also Reed, which is for divers. Divers use them to go under their wetsuits, but they're really warm, breathable, they're just really nice. I think it's really important to have a good base layer on, because that's what's direct with your skin, and then whatever else you put on, like different layers, keeps you warm. So yeah, they're the base layers I would choose. Really great. And then I'd say Rab do brilliant down jackets. I've got two of them now. They're absolutely amazing. I always wear them. Probably a little too much. I just use them a lot because they're really comfortable. They're warm, they're lightweight, and they also look nice, which is a bonus. And then for bushcraft, I usually have a Peter Storm jacket. It's a green jacket I wear in my videos. I think that's perfect because if a spark flies up at you or you're working with tools, I think that's a better jacket to wear. If I wore a Rab jacket around a fire, it would get a hole in it. Okay, thank you for your question. I hope that helps. The next one is from First Aider Robert. So he asked how are you coping with the lockdown? Coping really well. It's nice to be outside during these times. Just enjoying the sunshine. Spring is here. It's absolutely stunning seeing new life coming into play now. But yeah, I'm coping well. It's obviously a lot to adapt to and get used to, but it's okay. I hope your lockdown is going well also. Next question is from Ollie Twiggy. Is a hot dog a sandwich? It is if you want it to be. Ollie Twiggy again. Favourite pasta and what sauce? I would say... just traditional pasta, whatever that is. And I'd probably go for tomato and basil sauce. That's a go-to. Next question. So thank you for them questions. Next one is from Gareth Mert. Do you ever get freaked out? He's got hit in the face with a fly or something. Do you ever get freaked out camping? I'd say I used to. In the beginning, when I first do solos and things like that, I think you adjust to it, you get used to the noises of nature and outside, and you build up your own confidence. I don't think I do now, but I definitely used to when it was really new experience. Next one is from Greaves.86. You should try camping in the Brecon Beacons, Wales, when the lockdown is over. It's beautiful. Actually camped there a few times with my family and it was really nice. Also been on a trip there twice with a organisation helping young girls and boys get their bronze DV, which was really nice. We climbed up Penny Van, I think that's how you pronounce it in Welsh. And that was really nice. But yeah, it is a really stunning area. And there's a lot of places you can camp around there. So definitely want to head back. I was planning on going there this year if I did pass my driving lesson. But I guess that will wait. Next question is from Dan.Hudson1987. What is your favourite view? I would say probably mountains and lakes. But then... looking up now, this is a really pretty view. Just woodland with the sun coming through and the bluebells. But I'd have to say mountains and lakes with a bit of forest. Mix it all up. Next one is from Chuck Kalps. Have you tried seed collecting to grow your own trees? No, I haven't. That is something that's quite interesting though. Recently I've planted vegetables, but not trees. That would probably be really interesting. My dad has also started to make bonsai trees, so he's made these lovely bowls and planted mini saplings from different trees and going to make bonsais from them, which is really cool. Question from Ollie_Roots. How are you staying sane during quarantine? It isn't an awful lot different. It's just like being on a really long-term camp out. It's definitely different spending loads, like 24/7 with family and being outside 24/7. But it's a really nice experience. I'd say the best way to stay sane is keep yourself occupied and productive, and kind of, I love starting checklists, writing out what I want to do and plan out my days, what I want to get done. I think getting up early and starting your day early is really nice, and sort of sticking to a structured sleeping pattern. That does help a lot. You definitely do lose track of days and time, so yeah, I haven't been running a lot by time or the days. It doesn't really matter, but keeping a bit of structure and trying to learn as much as I can. Next one is from Chris Hewitt. What's your favourite mountain? I've never actually seen Snowdonia. That's meant to be really pretty around that area. Never been there. Went to Ben Nevis once and seen Scafell Pike, but they're like the big ones that are really popular for climbing. But I'd say for a favourite mountain, it would be one called Dob. I think that's how you pronounce it. Probably isn't. But I really like that mountain just because there's two mountains next to each other and they've got a really unique shape. And when I was there in January, me and my dad climbed it, and it's just a really good mountain. It's got a full summit, and when we got there it was snow on the top, so it was really pretty. And really nice view looking down Glenative Valley. That was stunning. So I'd probably say that one for the moment. David Cox, 58. How are you getting internet out in the woods? It's not like we're severely remote. You still get internet out here. So yeah, it's pretty decent. Next question is, what's your favourite thing to cook whilst camping? I'd say for now, as it's getting hotter, I prefer probably a steak with sweet potatoes or kebabs, something like that. Where in the winter time, more leaning towards stews and stuff like that. That's more on the agenda. So yeah, I like that question. It's lovely cooking food outside. Always tastes a lot better. Next question is, any tips on someone camping for the first time? I'd say best advice I could give was go with someone with your first time camping is probably ideal. One, you got someone there to fall back on if something goes wrong, and two, it just makes the whole experience more enjoyable, especially if you're new to it. Research into the right equipment to take, learn how to set it up, and what to do if it fails on you. I wouldn't go too remote or out the way or extreme weather when it's your first time. Probably best to go in the summer somewhere local. Next one is from Cheeky Runner. How long have you been doing wild camping? It's coming up to 4 years, which is really scary actually, because that has gone really quickly. But yeah, 4 years. Next question is Ronald Reynolds. Hey Becky, I'm going to ask you one more question. Are you interested in hunting and fishing? I have done a bit of fishing. I used to do carp fishing with my dad. Obviously that's not the kind of hunting approach, you put the fish back. But I've had some goes at it and it's really good fun. I enjoy it a lot. Recently purchased an air rifle, so, and we have hunting rights on the bit of woodland that we use, so maybe that's something that I might do in the future. Obviously don't want to kill an animal just for the fun of it, or if I'm not going to use it, if it's not essential to me, then I'm not going to kill something. For a lot of my campouts and my trips, I take my own food, so yeah, I'm not going to hunt food whilst I'm camping out, but it's definitely something that a skill to work on or learn just in case. Next question is, have you ever felt lonely? If yes, how many days after? I guess, times doing solos, but it kind of, it just is a quick feeling and then it just goes. Obviously times where you think, oh, I'm actually on my own and there's no one around. But I think personally I probably have to spend a longer duration on my own to really feel that emotion. So I don't think I've done a long enough solo to really feel that, for me personally. Other people will go out and they might feel more lonelier because they might be a real extrovert, or people might not get lonely at all. I think everyone's different, it's just relative to who you are. Next one is from Rebel with a Cause. Hi Becky, good to see you're still enjoying the great outdoors and staying away from the fear porn. I'd like to know what heating variants you have tried when heating a tent in the winter. Many thanks, have a wonderful day. For heating up the bell tent, we were kindly given a stove, a wood burning stove to put in there. The bell tent's got a flue hole, so we've put the flue through there and it heats up the bell tent really nicely. We also cook on there as well, so it's really good that it can do multiple things like boiling water, cooking and heating up the bell tent. Next question is, what are your top three positives of being in the great outdoors and one thing you miss? Stay safe and take care. Three positives is, I love being outside. I probably feel more home out here. It's just a lot more free. It's obviously a better place to isolate as you don't really see anyone. And it's great for learning new skills and also making video content and sharing my journey of this with other people. One thing I miss would be probably friends back home. Thank you for that question, that was really nice. Next question is, how do you handle fear during solo campouts, especially at night? I would say just being used to it and confident with what I'm doing and the area I'm in. And just getting used to the noises around you. So I know at night everything seems a lot louder and a lot worse than in the day. So by doing it more and getting that experience and confidence, then you'll just get used to the noises and the surroundings and it will just feel natural, I guess. You could also have a distraction, so by maybe making a fire, reading a book. Some people like to take a radio with them just to have that distraction. Next one is, are you going to change your channel name when you get older? Woman Outdoors. It's a good idea, but I think I'll just stick with Girl Outdoors. But I don't see the need to change it. I'm fine with what it is. So I'll probably stay the same with that one. So next question is from Count Basin Stokes Third. How's the archery going? Archery's going really well. I tried to do an hour a day practicing just to get really good and learn new techniques with the bow. So really enjoying that and learned quite a lot from it with instinctive shooting and things like that. So it's been good. Next one is from Stephen Taylor. Hi Becky, hope you're all well enjoying your lockdown. Thanks for sharing your vids. They have made my lockdown bearable. Stay safe, all the best to you and Mrs. and Mr. Bushwhacker and Lou. Thank you for that, that's really sweet. And I will enjoy lockdown. You stay safe as well, Stephen. Next one is from Rebel with a Cause. How do you keep warm at night if you don't want to be found? I guess that's linking to stealth camping. Probably take lightweight but warm sleeping bag and clothing instead of making a fire if you're stealth camping. So yeah, by having really good layering system, by having a nice base layer, bottoms and a top, and just layering up, but having a quality sleeping system, that will really help, and you don't really need a fire as much. I have a Rab Ascent 900 sleeping bag, and that is amazing. I don't really need a fire or a wood burner or something like that when I'm in that. Next question is from Tom Stowe-Lauren. How do you see climate change affecting bushcraft now or in the future? That is a really good question. Climate change is obviously making a huge impact on our lives, but I have to say, since being on lockdown, just being here in the space of 6 weeks, I've noticed a huge change with the pollution levels. Since they have banned a lot of flights and not as many people are travelling, public transport's been really decreased. There's a huge change, and the amount of star constellations I see now are crazy, and it's just, that's made a huge difference in the space of 6 weeks. From the whole world sort of shutting down, you can tell how bad and toxic these modern conveniences are for our planet, and they're not that very healthy for us, and there's a lot of pollution going around. So it's obviously affecting our environment, but also us. This might be the cause of a lot of diseases of today. By having so much exposure to pollution, it might cause a lot of lung problems later on for people in my generation and in the next. So I would say affecting bushcraft, maybe travel might be affected in the future. They might not want planes to run as much, so that might be a thing, you not being able to travel. Camping and making fires might be like frowned upon. It might be really kind of bad to go out and light a fire because it's increasing climate change, even though it makes a tiny, tiny difference compared to the mass scale of people, like planes and cars and military things. So yeah, I guess everything has a positive and a negative. If things do change due to climate change, obviously it will affect our enjoyment and our hobby of doing this sort of thing, but I guess it is for helping our planet. So I think I have now answered all the questions. Yep, answered all the questions. So thank you so much for all your lovely questions. I enjoyed doing that. Haven't done a Q&A in a while, so it's quite nice, quite different. Definitely will do some more if you wanted to ask a question but you missed it. But yeah, thank you for watching this. Hopefully it's something to pass the time in lockdown. I hope you're all staying safe and keeping well and keeping yourself occupied. Kind of say use this time wisely to spend it with your family or learn a new skill, or catch up on something that you've always been putting off because you've never had enough time. You'll probably notice how valuable time is and family is. I also want to say a huge thank you to everyone for supporting me and getting me to 60,000 subscribers. Absolutely crazy. So yeah, thank you so much. And thank you to all my amazing patrons. Much love, everyone. And I'll see you in the next video.